is still here. We focus on the next match, but now we know that we're not on top yet, and we still have to work hard. We know we have to work hard, but the game in West Brom really really got us thinking that there's a long way still. So maybe maybe it was good for us, but it's never fun to lose that way. We lose. We lost down there. Now we need some help because if West Brom wins the rest of the game, then we can't reach them. But yeah, I hope that they will lose one or two matches, and I'm sure that we can win the rest if we put on another level and work hard for it. Then anything is possible. We lost in West Brom, but we have to get back on track, and we haven't lost at home yet, and we're not going to start doing that at home against Celje. So it's hard work once again, and then we need 2 points if we want to win this group. We play difficult places with a lot of atmosphere, and the other teams that come here to Paris and Carpentier, they have to feel the same way, and we're really lucky to have this. To have this arena, and there's amazing atmosphere, especially when we play in Champions League. The way we played the first half is the way we want to play every matches. It was hard work, a lot of concentration, played hard in defense, and made it tough for Saison. But second half was. It was a waste of time for us. We took in 21 goals, and it was, yeah, it's just we were disappointed after because that's not the way we wanted to end the match because it was certain at halftime that we were going to win the match, but not this way. We speak about it on the team afterwards, and everyone agrees that's not the way we want to present ourselves, especially at home. Sometimes you can relax when the game is over, but not at halftime. And of course, Nocker was not satisfied either, and he shouldn't be because the last 30 minutes that was not good enough for our team. I still think it's amazing to be here at PSG and in Paris. I really enjoy it and I love playing here. I think I've stepped up and evolved as a player, but I also think that we evolved as a team already. There's still a lot of hard work and a long way to go, but I love being part of this process and I hope to reach a lot more. The way we play in France is a lot different from the way that I used to play in Denmark. It's more. It's maybe faster and much more tactical. Where here it's more physical all the time, and every match is really tough for us because, yeah, of course we try to be the best, and the other team they really want to beat us. So we meet a lot of tough opponents every week, and this is my first time that I play on a team that can and will try to win the Champions League. And this year's Champions League, with all good matches, it's really fun to try, but it's also tough when you play two times every week. Oui, c'est français, c'est très difficile. But it's getting better every week, and it's easier for me to understand. But it's still a problem speaking French. But yeah, my daughter's at school; she's already starting to get better than me. I think it's easier for her, but the handball French is okay, but the conversation is still the problem. But I enjoy it, and I'm sure that when this year is over, I will do this interview in French. He has the same drive on national team as he has here, but this is the first time that I experience him all week, every week, and I really love his drive and his motivation to always get better and yeah, not to to play any bad matches. He really wants to be on top of his game every game, and I admire that. That's really important for, of course, for him, but also for the team, because that makes us all better. I'm not surprised, but I'm really impressed. But I can say that about a lot of these guys. That there's a lot of hard work, and there's a excellent mentality on the team, because it's not just about all the games, and it's all about practice and getting better each day. And I really love that about being here. That's also why I'm getting better all the time.